years have come and gone since that day. How many years have I waited for this moment? For the one that stood alone against the storm. For the one they called.
Oh my gosh. It's so good. Hello! So, I do not know for sure if anything is too loud or too quiet or not. I'm assuming 14 is probably going to be too quiet because it's 14. And it's sort of like it's either all quiet or all obnoxiously loud, and there's no in between. But it's 14! So, hello. If anybody is watching this and actually knows who this is that randomly popped up in their feed, hi, it's been a little while. If you don't know who this is, then welcome. I apologize in advance because this is probably going to be very scuffed, as is. And this is kind of special because, and I specifically say this, I have the pleasure of getting to do something very, very special. And that is, oh, excuse me for just one moment, is, I get the pleasure of experiencing this expansion from the start with zero spoilers. Now, I have tried my absolute best for the better part of a couple years to avoid any and every single spoiler for this game. Actually, it looks like the audio is a little quiet, so apologies in advance. As I said before, this game has this weird thing of, like, it's either obnoxiously loud or obnoxiously quiet. Let's see if that's better. The levels are a little bit better. We'll turn up just a smidge. I can always fix the audio for myself right here, this headset. I have been wanting to do Final Fantasy XIV stuff on a stream for a while. And part of why I want to stream in general is I like the ability to do something fun and record myself and look back at it later and be like, oh yeah, I remember doing that stupid thing. God, I hate myself. But in this case, this is me getting to experience an amazing story for the first time with no spoilers of any kind. I've kind of known about some stuff going on since roughly, like, you know, ARR through Heavensward. I got a few spoilers told to me for, like, Stormblood. I may know a thing or two about what's going on here. I do know that this is kind of like the equivalent of, like, Cataclysm for WoW, except actually good. So it'll be interesting to see. I am experiencing the entire Shadowbringers content in the Shadowbringer, or the Dark Knight artifact gear from the start. In fact, this is the very first quest here to start it all off. So I look forward to seeing what we're getting. White oak coffer chest? Huh. I didn't even know what this stuff is. But we get the Shadowbringers! Ooh, I'm already excited. Okay. So, let's see where we go. Good news, Akima. We've had a stroke of luck in our search for that beacon. Really? Apparently, our colleagues have stumbled across a hidden path leading down to the hollows around the base of the Crystal Tower. Ooh, so Crystal Tower quest line, before Nero left, he threw that little beacon or whatever, and it started beeping. I wonder if they find that down there, too. Let's see what we got. Okay. A path I doubt we'd ever have found had the Ironworks and the Suns not added their numbers to the party. Thanks to them, we have eager eyes apparently down there, checking under rocks and peering into every nook and cranny. Still, it sounds like there's a lot of ground to cover. Then we better go and give him a hand. The key is working, but it says waiting around us. Come on! Come on! Which do you think I'm gonna go for this one. Of course! I want to go help my friends! Friendship! My thoughts exactly! I love Tataru's new voice, by the way. Or, new. I've seen a friend streaming through and doing the ARR questline to try to get to Heavensward, and they are now officially in Heavensward, so it's kind of cool to see the voice change for Tataru, and I love Tataru's voice. The sooner we find that beacon, the sooner you can travel to wherever it is this mysterious voice is coming from. Yep! And the sooner we can work out how to help our friends. Sure enough, we have to find a way to wake them up, and before the Emperor comes calling again, meaning that we have no time to lose. Yep! even though I'm like almost an entire expansion behind, but we're not gonna talk about that. There's a boat to the north, Silver Tears, waiting to ferry people to the site, so let's head on our way.
Okay.
Yo, that quest music though? Oh, that's good. I like that. I like that. Let's see.
It looks like audio is doing pretty good so far.
I'm gonna probably be, because this is a stream, I'm gonna be uploading this to YouTube later, so hopefully it's not too bad, but I am gonna be asking anyone that pops in here, like, how are levels, how's audio, how's stuff like that. I'm probably gonna be louder than the music, which is fine. It's kind of what I would prefer for it to be anyway. Also, as a heads up, I have a very nice, I don't know if I can even show it, yeah I can, mechanical keyboard. It is a Razer Tournament Edition keyboard, and unfortunately, because it is a Razer Tournament Edition keyboard, it's a 10 keyless one, which is part of why I got it, because I like having the less cramped space. The only downside with it, unfortunately, is that it is a bit loud, so you might hear, and I'm sure the mic picked that up and everything, so I apologize in advance for that, but as this is just kind of a fun casual stream, I'm not too perturbed by it. I actually prefer it. And yes, I shall, because I love this mount. I love the music for the Alexander raid, even though I've never done it myself. Oh, just listen to that. Ah, the music is so good. Soken is such a freaking... he's so good. All right. And as it is tradition, or attempted tradition, I'm trying to level up a job that's at least somewhat related to the theme of the expansion. I want to try and get a paladin from 1 to 80 in preparation for Endwalker. I'm probably not going to be doing Endwalker on time anyway, but I don't care. I've been taking my time with this game, and I'm thoroughly enjoying this expansion and everything so far, so I'm just going to take my time like I said I would. Into the survey site, ma'am. It's on the eastern shore of the lake, and the swiftest way to get there is by boat. Yep, let's go. Ooh. Oh, hey, Hori is here. What's up, bud?
Akima, the search continues, but I have no doubt we shall find this beacon of yours.
Cool. Oh, and,
Oh, no, that's not her, is it? No, that's a different Ironworks member.
Anor. The Archon needs our help. Next to that, even matters of the heart don't seem to matter.
Okay. Clemens? I detected no slavering beasts in the vicinity. My sister expected. Alright. Ironworks is out in force. Master Garland's orders.
Nice! Sons of Saint Koinok, I remember y'all.
A towering edifice is the outer wall of the Crystal Tower's foundation, the Labyrinth of the Ancients, to be precise.
Yep, I remember a friend was in there.
Colonnais? Is that how you say that name?
I apologize in advance if Jack watches the stream later. I am horrible with French, so I apologize.
The air here weighs heavy upon me. Tis little wonder, I suppose, when standing in the shadow of such an imposing structure.
I mean, yeah, I can't even turn the camera up that high, but Crystal Tower, yippee-ki-yay. All right, Tartar, what's up?
I should turn my own nameplate off. That can get annoying.
Let's chit-chat with each other. Aw, all these people coming to hell. It's kind of nice.
Look how many people there are.
I just said that.
Should we get to it then? Pick up anything that seems the least bit device-like, and we'll make ourselves a pile.
Okay. Sounds good.
Well, if it isn't the hero of the hour, maybe you'll change our look. We found bugger all without you.
Oh my god! I've never heard Biggs's voice before, or I forgot it! Is he a freaking Irishman? Oh my gosh, I love Biggs's voice!
Biggs! Wedge!
Aww. Her boy's here.
I love it.
Aye, aye. Well, we could hardly say no to a call for aid from the Scions.
I love Pig's voice. I'm just going to say it right now. I have never heard it before until now, and I love
Jesse
his voice.
Jesse called the chief for some other business, so we'll be working twice as hard to make up for his not being here.
That works.
Thrice as hard, even.
I don't
Thank
know if I like that.
Both of you. I'm sure we'll
I
find
love Tataru's
in no
voice.
Time.
It's so cute, but it's like... It's not like...
Oh, Lalafell voice.
I like her voice a lot. It's really good. Okay. And so far, we haven't had a bunch of bad frames, which is nice. I cut out a bunch of miscellaneous stuff in the background. In fact, one moment. Let me cut out even more. Try and save my frames as much as I can.
I'm not seeing anything out here. Do you reckon you could squeeze in there, Wedge?
And get stuck halfway? No, thank you.
That's a little better.
I could try if you like.
Wedge, you're getting stood up by Tataru? Seriously, dude?
Tataru, no! We couldn't ask you to do that.
Oh, I'll be fine. This receptionist is not afraid to get her hands dirty.
Nice. Wait.
Sorry, I meant to say, the scholars haven't finished their preliminary assessment of the site yet, so we're not supposed to venture too far in. What's that you got there?
It's a gear.
Now with... that looks promising.
It's a gear with. Is that? That almost looks like
isn't
they're.
Isn't that the ironworks symbol? Counterfeiters?
Yeah. It's a different ironwork symbol. Oh, here we go.
Now I have you.
You are right.
What's happening?
Stay with me. Focus on my voice.
All right.
Let expanse contract. Eon become instant.
Wait, this must be it. The device. Well, this is supposed to happen.
Throw wide the gates that we may pass.
I've been hearing that so many times in the last few years.
Safe journey, warrior of light. Find our friends and bring them home.
Wow! Tataru actually, like, with it. That's great. That's cool. And we're doing our thing. I've been waiting for this. All right, come on. Show me, show me, show me. Let's go. Okay, we're in the expanse, that makes sense. Okay. Oh, we're drifting now. Okay, interesting. So we're getting pulled along. Okay.
Okay. Oh, do not look at me so.
You assholes! God bless! Oh, that was mean!
We did everything right! Everything that was asked of us, and still it came to this!
Missed it, okay. Is that who I think it is?
Your time has not yet come.
Oh yeah! Nice, okay. I'm already in this, let's go. That's us. Wait. That was the warriors who got brought back. My poor computer with its poor graphics can't have anything but two pixel wide plants. At least we look good though.
From endless dreams I awake. Something vague, yet urgent, calls me to action once more.
I feel bad because the trees do not look that good. I wish I could turn the graphics up. Chocobo. Wait.
To meet someone out here is not a peddler himself. What brings you into the wilds this time of night?
Meat? What do you mean by this time of night?
Well, if it ain't the oldest joke in the book. Me granddad, God's rest his soul, used to tell that one to the barman a kicking out time.
I'm genuinely confused as well.
And when, pray tell, did we last have a dark night? You rotten old drunk yet, he'd reply.
Ooh, he's hitting the ball
hard. Over 100 bleeding years ago, that's when. You got that look down to a T. I'd almost think you meant it. Ah, got to you, did they? Poor beggar. That explains it then.
I'll pass. I remember this.
Well, I've roads to travel and wares to sell, but you best hurry along to the town nearby.
Aww.
Just head east through the trees and aim for the Shining Tower. You'll find the place soon enough. Tis the biggest settlement for Malms around. Go on now, friend. They'll take good care of you in the Crystarium.
I don't trust this worth a jack, but...
Dizzying heights it rises, the gleaming spire. Its tip threatening to pierce the blinding canopy. There, it will all begin anew. Between dark and light, the pure and the corrupt. The one true struggle.
Oh! is such a good intro. Oh, I'm excited. I'm swapping my sleeves here. I can't make up my mind. Oh, it's so pretty. All right, so go down the road. I can't even mount up. Okay. You're gonna make me walk it. Okay. Oh, I'm looking forward to leveling up as Dark Knight. So just a heads up for anybody who does pop in here and wonders, we're going to be focusing on Dark Knight because it's story, and Red Mage because it's the job that got me to play 14 and stick with it, and it's one of my favorite jobs in the game, so... Crystal Tower in another world, okay. Ooh, let's see. What do we got? Kind of funny that I'm here as a Dark Knight. I don't know if that's going to cause any problems or not. Ooh, hi! I'm in Vera, where I come from.
Every face in this city I know. Yours, I do not.
I like her voice.
This is the threshold of the Crystarium, stranger, and I am its gatekeeper. If you would enter, you will answer my questions.
Okay.
From where do you hail?
That's a long source. Oh god, I read this source. That's a long story. I'm gonna go with the source. I mean, I could say Uldah.
The source? What is this cryptic nonsense?
I mean, I could tell you Uldah, you're not gonna believe me.
Had you given me an honest answer, I would not have barred your way. We care little here for a person's place of origin, but instead, you chose concealment. And I will not suffer you to pass.
I mean, if I told you the truth, you wouldn't have believed me either. Light.
That one had eaten. It must have gulped down the whole hand, ring and all.
No! 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 Already? Oh, shit.
Everything all right, Captain?
Oh, you...
Quite all right, my lord. Just a stray sin eater, and a weak one at that.
I see. Weak or not, we should be on the lookout for more.
I'm angry already.
But I see you've met my guest. I will escort her to the Crystarium myself, if you've no objections.
Another of your mysterious friends, is it? I should have known.
Another?
Pretty well. I'll inform the others your guest is to be given the run of the city. Pray forgive my less than cordial welcome. May the rest of your stay with us be a pleasant one.
What's your name?
Come with me. I will answer whatever questions you have when we are somewhere more private.
The music riffs are really good already.
Right then, before we plunge into the wheres and wherefores, let me first thank you for answering my summons.
Answering? You kind of didn't give me a choice.
I had intended to bring you directly to my personal quarters, but I fear my aim was slightly off. That you're still able to make the crossing unharmed is a great relief. And so, we come to the question of where. The realm in which you now find yourself belongs to one of the 13 reflections, or shards. The first, to be precise, even if its inhabitants are largely oblivious to the fact. As to wherefore, having been awarded the rather grandiose title of Crystal Exarch, I, in my capacity as caretaker of the Crystarium, thought to seek the aid of you and your companions.
Oh, so you did take them intentionally, okay. Oh yeah, no. Do you know how much trouble you've caused?
An inkling, yes. I can only beg your forgiveness. Matters here forced my hand. But all shall be explained in due course, I promise you.
How about you flick the hood up, jerkwad? I want to understand what's going on.
Let us begin with the glaring skies up above. Here in the first, the world has been all but consumed by primordial light.
Yeah, I knew about this.
It began a century ago, by this realm's reckoning. A luminous flood swallowing everything in its path. More than 9/10 of this star was lost. And the fortunate few who survived are hounded by abominations born of that catastrophe even now.
So this is technically an umbral catastrophe, even though it's the light.
Sin eaters, we call them. The creature you saw earlier was one such monstrosity. It was to save the first from this menace that I learned to bridge the rift between worlds, that I might call upon the aid of the greatest of heroes. And though it meant depriving a world of its champion, I had to try. For in saving the first, you would bring salvation to the source as well.
And would you look at that? I wasn't lying. I said the source, and yeah, I wasn't lying.
But what manner of host harangues his guests in the middle of the road? Let us continue our talk within the Crystarium.
Who are you? I really, really want to just walk over and like, boop, flick the hood off his head and be like, all right, jerkwad, who are you? What's up? Oh, hold on. Come on. Yes! I think if you go back and you watch the original trailer for Final Fantasy XIV, the dome that's here, if I'm not mistaken... Yep! I'm pretty sure the dome that's here, if you look in Final Fantasy XIV...
Vibrant city. The sole sanctuary for the living in a world all but resigned to oblivion. Each stone was laid with hope. The town itself a symbol. A monument to defiance in the face of death.
Okay.
No would-be hero could fail to answer its call. For who among us does not yearn for salvation?
Wait a minute. That was the beast tribe that summoned Ifrit. Okay. All right, Crystal XR, let's go. Ah, yeah. Welcome, my friend, we're starving. Alright, now we get the cool stuff, whatever's in here. Oh! I don't want to level up too quickly, but at the same time, you know, as every streamer should, we gotta, stay hydrated. So. Let me check out what we got. So we got the orchestration scroll for Shadowbringers. Awesome. Theater of the Band. What's this? It's determined by the job when opening. So, my red mage is already 71. Oh, hold on a second. Cool, I want to make sure. My job is already red mage is at 71, so there's no point in me opening that. We're going to open this as Dark Knight. That's kind of cool. Nice, okay. That's a start. Oh, they're going to slowly gear me up for the baseline here. That's nice. So Exarch has a request for you. Okay. Now, a full and frank discussion of the privacy must be able to see in order. But I think our conversation would be meaningful first. Gain a firmer grasp of the situation here. Then I don't like you to do civil leader. It's okay. There's the ether right there. Yep. Got it to that. Right. Being the right object of my summons, well, you should in theory be able to back all your gear trail and find connection and source, believe it or not. Strongly suggest. Okay, I get that. After you have done so, walk up the steps to the next ether and try to the left. So go through here. Crystal mean either there or there. We'll find out. Walk up the steps. Yeah, so we gotta go up and out that way. You'll find our collective of crafters and gatherers, as well as their spokeswoman, Catlis. Like you to meet. Okay? So that's the crafting area. Morin, to reach him and his cabinet of curiosities, you'll want to avoid the aforementioned steps, take the exit to the left, and simply continue straight along and down to the path. Okay? Ay, 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 ay. Am I dropping frames? I don't quite like how things are looking on my stream here, but we'll work with it. Third and final person to meet is Bragi, our man in charge of trade distribution. He's been on the markets, which should access up so the ether. Okay. Let's up and stairs and to the right. In seeking out each of my colleagues, you will visit major districts of the city and hopefully gain a feel for the place. I trust my adventure to the temple enough. Oh, I'm kind of tempted to play dumb. You know, we will. I don't pick these options that often. Say what now? My apologies, I know, forget how confusing Chris Starman being because of noise, I'm sure twists and turns. In all honesty, the true challenge may be in finding the right way to approach its citizens. As you discovered during your encounter with the captain, the people of this world are unaware of the existence of other stars and will struggle to accept the truth of your origins. Yeah, so I'm gonna play dumb. I tried that, it didn't work. That being the case, when they ask you hail, as in will, so should you claim that you share a homeland with the Crystal Exarch. There's an unspoken rule here about peering too deeply into that particular mystery. Okay. When you finish making the rounds, pray meet me in the large courtyard at the center of town. Till then. Take off your freaking hood. I am not gonna lie, I love the music tuning for this. This is really cool. Okay. So, first things first, as every new Final Fantasy player should know, whenever you get somewhere new or important, always, always. And they even make it a quest item. You need to attune with it. They want you to attune with it. Oh, somebody just passed away. Sweet. By focusing the senses, you check the flow of vast distances, vastest currents of ether. Connections on me to these energies are faint but stable and should allow you to teleport to etherites in the source. So, funnily enough, they retcon it by saying, oh, well, because I pulled you through the ether, you can go back home if you want. I can't, technically, because, you know, stuff. I gotta do the thing here. So, I am so excited. I have not spoiled anything for myself for this story. I am beyond ecstatic for it, because everybody swears this is the best expansion. And I'm sorry, my hopes are really high, because when I played Heavensward, I was floored. I cried. I legit cried, because that expansion was so good. You know, for this being the main hub, I'm surprised there aren't more people here. Unless it's just because of the events and stuff. Which, we gotta do. So, at the time of recording this, we are in the point in the game where we are getting our irregular tombstones of lore to get cool items. I've already got the jacket for this. I've already gotten, I think, a few of the orchestration scrolls. But I need to get the other stuff. I need to get the rest of the, cosmetics for the caster set or whatever. So I need to get that done for sure. Oh, I gotta get this as well, because etheric shards are always important. In fact, this is gonna be the first thing I do. I apologize. The beginning of this is probably gonna be a little boring. I'll be talking to people every now and then, but etheric shards is, as we know, one of the most important things you need to do. I gotta go down for that. Let me go ahead and do this. Catley, I'll talk to you in a bit. Oh my gosh, this music is so good! Wait, am I not allowed to hop up here? So I guess I go up the stairs for you, are you sure? I'll go talk to Catley in a second, but... Oh my gosh, soak in! This is so good! Holy cow! Cool. I need to drop down to get the rest of these, so I'll keep that in mind for now. Huh. Passer. Come look for work. I might have a spot for another guard. I'm good. Thank you. Ouch. I broke my glankles. Hi, Catley. Or Catlets, sorry. Better see a place so well stocked of goods, isn't it? Well, not here. Hi! I'm going to guess you're new to our fair city. Oh, for what it's worth, you've chosen a fine sanctuary. The Exarch can throw up a barrier if the Sinners come knocking, so it's a damn sight safer in here than it is out there. Safer and more civilized, too. Thanks to us in the mean. We work together to procure materials and resources and craft the goods which make the city life possible. This is the place to visit if you need a coat mended or a kettle forged. Okay, I have actually heard one thing, a kettle forged. I do know a little something. Just don't go thinking it'll all be handed to you on a plate like those Yule Morans layabouts. Here in the Crystarium, we work for a living. Cool. Though I see you're no stranger to honest labor, you don't have a whiff of indolence about you like some folks I've met. Still, I can't quite pin down your profession. Where is it you're from? One of the Exarch's countrymen, you say? I see. Well then, I'll work twice as hard to make you feel welcome. Our city wouldn't even exist if it weren't for him, and any friend of his is a friend of ours. Hey! Somehow I'm getting preferential treatment right off the bat. Just a little messed up, but anyway. It's really quite incredible when you think about it. They say his grand magic summoned the Crystal Tower into existence. Pulled the entire thing out of thin air. I don't know about that. It wasn't long before droves of refugees became congregating around its base, desperate for shelter and losing their homes to the flood. And that's how the Crystarium began. At the Exarch's invitation, buildings started going up, and with the help of some curious relics brought forth from the tower, the place gradually expanded into the thriving metropolis you see today. Cool! Cities stood here for decades now, yet the eldest amongst us swear the Exarch looks exactly the same he did back then. He is indeed a man of many mysteries, but for all his secrecy, he has never let us down. So, if he, and you, wish to remain silent about your shared homeland, the folk here will respect your wishes for privacy. I am, however, more than a little curious to see any crafting talent you might be hiding, and if you've ought to contribute on that, be sure to come back and visit once you've had a chance to settle in. Just ask for Catalyst, and I'll find you a niche here in the crystalline mean. You can help us get the cogs, or you can help us keep the cogs of the city greased and turning. Cool! Hey, I've got somebody!
I know nothing.
I don't know anything, actually. I do know we get some really, really dope music in the Twinny, and I am very looking forward to that. And, you know, some stuff about teapots, tea kettles, kettles in general. I know a little bit about that. Oh my gosh. I am, like, nerding out so hard right now because I've been wanting to, number one, stream for a while, but number two, I've been trying to keep myself away from spoilers for this expansion in particular and just take it and enjoy it. Yep, the meme is the real deal, and the fairy music is... Yo! Oh, what's it called? Oh, I know the song. I knew the name of the song because I haven't even played any of the raids or anything yet, but I watch a YouTuber named Drac Gamenstein, and when he took on Titania, who I know about Titania, so I know some spoilers there, but Titania's theme is so good. At first you're just sitting there and you're like, what is this? And of course the meme is always true because it's like, at first you're like, what is this? Second time, oh, this isn't too bad. Third time, la 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 la. It's in on the wind, here we come again to round and round the bend, fa la la la. It's so good. I think it's like As We Fall Down or something like that. I can't remember the actual theme, but What Angel Wakes Me, thank you. Yes, no, I am so excited. I am so excited. I cannot wait to enjoy this. Also, hello and welcome. How are you doing? I'm gonna hold off on that actually, because every good Final Fantasy 14 player knows. Oh, I don't have to get any more here. You won't be seeing her for a couple hours. I do understand that. I don't expect to see a lot for a couple of hours, honestly, only because of the fact that, frankly speaking, I don't expect to be able to stream a ton. I actually prefaced everything I started with I'm going to try and do this at least on Thursdays if I can, because I have all of Friday off, but I'm in like my last month and a half of college, so I'm going to focus on that and then have Thursday be like my chill day, so we'll see what happens. I intend to stream next Thursday, though. No stopping there. Of course, this is where I get the kappa from Kaotaka, because, you know, sure you will. Anyway, let's talk to Morin. Actually, one moment. I swear, mic dust will, like, frickin' pile up quicker than you can blink, and I hate it. Alright, I gotta take the shirt off, because it's getting a little hot in here. This is what happens when you've got a computer in a small room with very, 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 very good insulation. Aww. Excuse me, miss. Are you recently come to the city, perchance? I'm quite familiar with our civic rules, you see, and... Well, hi. What's up? Aww. What I mean to ask is, have you brought any books with you? A rubble scroll, even? A scrap of scribbled on parchment? We got a book nerd over here. It's okay, everyone needs a hobby, and you're stuck here, so... My apologies. Those are just something of an obsession of mine, as well as a profession. Nice! Librarian Morin, at your service. And this humble collection is known as the Cabinet of Curiosities. As your powers of perception have likely informed you, my colleagues and I are responsible for curating all matters of tomes, documents, and other vehicle of the written word. Nice. As horrific as the loss of life and land wrought by the flood unquestionably was, the damage to recorded knowledge was no less catastrophic. We few do all we can to preserve that wisdom which survived. That is actually very true. One of the worst things possible is the loss of history. if you are getting rid of stuff, the fact that, you know, important things happen and we try to just write them out, that's really rough, because we should know about it and we should learn from it and improve on it, not get rid of it. That's why it sucks whenever a civilization gets taken over by another one and it falls, because then all that history, like, fun fact, sorry to derail here, I believe it's the Celts, if I'm not mistaken, have an entire mythos that's just gone now because, yay Christianity, we destroyed it all. I am a Christian as well, so slight shame there. But anyway, moving on, let's actually focus on the game, not other stuff. But tell me, what brings you to the cabin today? Looking for any town in particular? Mayhap a spot of academic research? Oh, you sound so excited, I feel bad. So you plan to go through as Dark Knight, not Ninja? So the plan, hey, Atake, I have been trying to, and I don't always have this option, but I have been trying to level up the jobs that are responsible for the expansion, or like the face of the expansion, and with the only exception being A Realm Reborn and Stormblood, I leveled up the appropriate job for it. I've never really been interested in Warrior, and I kind of feel like ARR is like the job you do whatever with. In ARR, it's like pick your job, that's kind of the face you play. Heavensward, I did Dragoon. I got Samurai up to about 55 and was gonna level that through the expansion for Stormblood, but I just could not stand it. It's not that it's a bad job, it's just that it's a very bland job. It's very straightforward. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Midori Setsu Gekka, pump your abilities. It was boring as crap. So I did Ninja instead, because ninjas are very much involved in the Stormblood story. For this one, we're doing Dark Knight, and sorry about the mic. For Endwalker, I'm gonna try. It opens up when you level a bit. I have a 70 or a 71, it's pretty fun. Okay, cool. I'm not saying that Samurai's bad at all. Like, Monk for me was also a bit frustrating, and I had somebody who plays this game tell me that, like, oh, well, you know you don't have to go back, flank in order to do your combo, right? You can literally move two buttons around and do all back and all flank, and that made my mind just explode because I didn't think about it that way. But regardless, I memed on Ninja really hard and refused to give it a try. And because I refused to give it a try, because it was very Naruto and I despise Naruto now, I wouldn't try it. So when I finally did start playing Ninja and I got to the part where you start getting your mudras and your ninjutsu and stuff, I fell in love and stuck with that through Stormblood instead. I will eventually get around to getting Samurai up the rest of the way. I think I've got it to 60 now, so I could technically do Stormblood content if I want to, but I'm okay with not doing it. I'm gonna just stick with, if I've got any jobs I'm gonna stick with, my main job will always be Red Mage. I'm gonna level that beside Dark Knight this expansion. I don't care if I have to take extra time to do it or not, I'm gonna do it. Dark Knight because it's the face of this expansion. I'll eventually get Paladin from 1 to 80 so I can do Endwalker, but that's way down the line. I don't expect to be caught up until after Endwalker's out, so I'm not worried about it. And I'm gonna do Ninja as my melee job, so just gonna have some fun with this. I'm gonna take my time, I'm gonna have a good time. Back to story! Sidetracking over. Oh ho, so you're an interest in modern history. Splendid! A thorough review of recent events can often yield novel perspective, I quite agree. If you would prefer something visual to account the to accompany the account, then I think I have an illustrated history book for children somewhere. Just a moment, I'll fetch it for you. I'm gonna get a kid's book to explain my stuff? Are you kidding me? I'm reading a kid's book for this. Oh my gosh, that's a joke. Don't know how much tank experience you have, but it's pretty difficult in Shadowbringers. I can carry you in your dungeons if you need. I appreciate it. I will pass for now. I kind of want to just, again, experience things as I go. As it is, it took me a while to get TBN and a few other things, so I'm just going to enjoy this and experience it as I go for now. And here we are. Would you like to pull up a chair? Make yourself more comfortable? On with the lesson, then. Aww. He looks so excited. It's so cute.
Ooh. 100 years ago, or near enough not to matter, villains known as the Warriors of Light slew the Shadow Keeper, the Steward of Darkness. In the wake of this tainted deed, light began to pour into the world as if from unseen cracks. It pooled and swelled without cease, until the day an enormous, blinding wave rose up and swept across our star. We call this calamity the Flood of Light. Everything it touches was leached of life and vigor, leaving naught behind but a luminous wasteland.
That is interesting. It's funny how in storytelling we always associate like light with good and darkness with bad. And I do remember people talking about how this was kind of like a horror game, because it's the concept of what happens if you have too much light? Is it really that good? So, definitely interesting. Let's see. I also love the music riffs in this. This is so good.
Hey! It's Minfilia!
Oh, I'm so excited.
Yet just when we thought all would be lost, a savior appeared before us. Yeah, she is pretty cool. The Oracle of Light. She stood twixt us and approached doom. By her powers did she stay the flood. Thus was Norvant, and Norvant alone spared the fate of Erasure.
Okay, so that's why the Warriors of Darkness got.
You mean Shadowbringers actually does something?
Duh, I know. I'm gonna be an ass about it, jeez.
Tragedy would, however, arrive in another form. From the blasted emptiness of descended horrors of strange and terrible aspects to bedevil the new folk who survived. These Sin Eaters were light incarnate, and their fulgent presence stole the nights from Norvant's sky. I cannot read this at all. Norvant's sky. There we go. Even now, they circle the remaining bastions of civilization, ever on the hunt for us, ever hungry our flesh. Okay.
Well, that's a depressing kid's book. And the shadow on his face, it's kind of ironic. And thus did the world become what it was. Did you ever wish to hear the tale again? I would be glad to retell it for you. Or if you would rather I speak of other matters, that too would be my pleasure. I should be glad to... should be glad of the company. Hey... I like him. He's a little nerdy, he's a little unsure of himself, understandably so, because, you know, he's just a bookworm. I like him. I like people like that. They're very much into what they enjoy, and we shouldn't judge them, ever. Did I get the coffer? No, I have to turn the quest in to get the coffer. I think it'll be quicker if I just go to the main plaza. Yeah, let's do that. Now we're thinking with portals. Wait. That is actually adorable. I don't know what that is, but that is cute. Alright, other way. I think the rest of the Aetherite shards around the city are going to be out and about here. I'm going to go take care of this one and then I'll head it back. But anyway, welcome! Seasonal event item. Oh, is that from the current season item? Wait. No, it must be an older one, I guess. Either way. It's no big deal. I haven't really stuck around to do seasonal events just because, again, I get on so infrequently because life, that I just kind of let them happen. The only stuff I try and get on for are the limited time events. Like, for example, I did do the, Final Fantasy 15 event, so I've got the car and all the stuff. Summer event. That makes sense. I played a little bit over the summer, but I didn't worry about, like, the holiday event stuff. I'll probably start looking at that a little bit more once things have settled. But for now, not a big deal. Only thing I care about is MSQ for this and doing the irregular tomes stuff for now. So, we'll see. We'll see what else happens, what comes along, and I'll enjoy event stuff a little later on. Well, there's Braggy or Broggy. But first things first, shard time. Then I gotta grab the one for the pendants, and I think I'll have them all. Let's find out. Oh, are you excited for Sage coming out, Keitake? I don't know if that's a job you'll switch to or not, because I know you ran White Mage for a bit. Alright, I'll be honest, I have never figured out what IIRC stands for. I'm crusty, so I've never figured out all the acronyms of the internet. And absolutely, yeah, I mean, with it being 14, I kind of expect everyone to want to do all the jobs, which, if I recall correctly. Gotcha. Thank you very much. Me and my internet brain has expanded slightly. I know for a fact, like, I know everyone's going to freak out about Reaper. Reaper is the one that I'm excited for because I always like melee DPS jobs. Funny enough, I'm going to focus on Red Mage before I focus on anything other than Dark Knight because of MSQ. But Red Mage is number two, and that's the one that no matter what expansion it is, no matter what's going on, I will be leveling that up. Also, as I said before, gotta, you know, hydrate, so might as well do what my Mikote is doing. Have high levels in all healing classes. 80 White Mage, 50 Astro and Scholar. Looking forward to Sage. I watch dev stuff and it looks nice. It does. It's kind of funny because a lot of people are relating it to like Disc Priest and WoW. So, I'm okay with whatever. I don't really have a lot of jobs up that high. I haven't really touched Gunbreaker or Machinist since they've dropped. I haven't even picked up Arcanist at all to do Summoner or Scholar, which is bad on my part. But anyway, all right, let's go ahead and move on with this. Broggy! I think I had Disc Priest when I was playing WoW, so it'll fit right in. Yeah, makes sense. I'm a little worried that they're going to be a little OP because it's like, I'm going to do damage to heal, which if they're smart, they'll do low damage numbers and like decent healing numbers. That way it's not much different from anyone else. Either way. You're the city friend. The spinning head and wide eyes gives you away. Ah, I do love the look of this place. Welcome. My name is Broggy, and I'm the master of these markets. They gave the district another official tile, but not in the habit of using it. Too florid by half. In any case, our merchants stock a range of equipment for Miss Stell, such as yourself. So finding something in your size shouldn't be a problem. Cool. It's a barrier here, so it'll be balanced around that. That's fair. I think they're splitting between regen and like raw healing, technically. So it makes sense that maybe that'll lean more towards barrier healing, and hopefully at some point down the line, Scholar will lean a little more towards like actual heal over time effects. We'll see. I do know a lot of people are pissed as Scholar players. I'm actually in defiance of Sage. If I'm going to main heal anything, I was going to do Astro, but now with everything happening to Scholar, I'm going to main Scholar if I do heal anything. And we got to go with this one because, you know, I'm actually a Mikote. Must be a dialect I'm not familiar with. Let's see if we can straighten this out. See those two in front of us? The short one is a Hume. And the taller one is an Elf. Okay. The sturdy individual there is a Garlgent. Well, it's the one with the horns is a Drawn. Interesting. And then you have the large, scaly chaps with long tails and knacks for raising livestock. Those would be the Zun. And I just look so confused. Scholar got bopped. Scholar as a job kind of got the short end of the stick because they didn't get any grand sweeping changes and stuff, and they still have pet healing. But I think people are blowing it out of proportion. We'll see. And Broggy saying, which is apparently not the name you know them by. Now, if I'm curious to know which far-flung region you hail from, and we tell him the same shtick as before. Ah, the same as the Exarch, eh? Well, that explains it. But don't get much further. You don't get much further flung than that. We've had a few of your lot pass through in recent years, and despite their obvious learning, they floundered over the simplest things. But not to worry, should you find yourself confused by the local language or the customs, I'll be here to answer your questions. Cool. So now we have to go to the Exarch, wherever he is. And I can use the shot to hop over the yaw. The Docile's Gate, or the Docile's Gate. Advance the quest! Advance the quest! Lore! Let's go! Well, how did you fare? Did my colleagues help you form a clearer picture of this world and its people? Oh, I didn't even know I had these. Life in the Crystarium. An account of how the Exarch summoned the Crystal Tower in the city built by the refugees to shelter them. Cool. An account of how the Warrior of Light caused the flood, which later led to the appearance of the city. Ooh, excuse me. An account of how the races of the source are known by different names in the first. Cool. Yes, it seems you were treated to a most thorough introduction. I understand it was something of a chore, but 'twas necessary that you grasp the names before we proceed. That's fine. As for the Crystal Tower's origin, you may have noted that details were sparse. The structure is, in fact, the self-same one you know from the source, transported to the first in its entirety. It was my first attempt at breaching the boundaries between worlds, something of a trial run for your eventual crossing. Though I do not know which era I tore it from, I do know that its arrival served to set the wheels of fate in motion. Okay. So, what I am now finding out is that you suck, because the Crystal Tower is supposed to be this pillar of society in every single region, and you might have just screwed a region over. Why did you do that? Why would you do that? Oh, ass. Anyway. Give me my chest, and let's... How do I not... I have another one, don't I? I do not, okay. Where's that chest? Here we go. Now I've got a chest piece. What does it look like? Probably disgusting compared to the rest of my character. Not bad, actually. Christopher finds ready. Discuss the matter of your comrades' whereabouts. Does requested and learn something of the world in which you find yourself. Now it's time for my half the bargain. Explain what has befallen your comrades. Yay! It's complicated. What about this game isn't complicated? That's a conversation I'd rather have in the privacy of my quarters, however. I must go ahead to the tower and organize a few things, but I shall see to it the guards know to admit you in. Wait. I'm not familiar with a name. Is there something I should know? An extraordinary tale, but I'm afraid I found no such individual residing in the tower when I passed into my care. Mayhap we revisit that mystery in old time. For now, I think it best we focus on the present. Who are you? Jeez. This guy is an ass, and I want to kick his butt for doing ass things. Ass things, like Assians. Greetings, madame. The Exarch awaits for you within. Yes, enter the Crystal Tower. Favorite side from waifu, why is he Ishtola? I don't know if Ishtola is my favorite Scion waifu. I do love Ishtola, though. She's an awesome character. Alright, take the hood off.
Welcome to the Ocular, my private study. We can speak here without fear of being overheard. I have much to explain, but the truths which I must touch upon in doing so would cause only distress and confusion to the people of this world.
Okay.
Pray keep that in mind. Now, I am sure you are desperate to know the fate of your fellow Scions.
To put it simply,
they are here in the first. Their arrival, however, was not as recent as you may imagine. Here, time flows at a different pace from that of the source.
Okay.
In the space of a single hour in your home world, an entire year might pass in the first, and the reverse could also be true. The pace fluctuates without rhyme or reason, and it cannot be predicted.
Great! So, never actually heard English voices like this, never thought of him as a Brit. So, the thing is that the English voices are actually proper English, because we had American voices for ARR, they sucked. So, when Yoshi P took over the game fully after the fact, the European voices are the same for the American voices. Like, the same VAs are doing the English for us, so we're just all British. Also, a couple things. One, this means that in theory, I could be here for 5 years fixing stuff, and 500 would pass in my realm. So, thanks for that, Exarch. Also, that means that after all the hours that have been sucked up by, like, everything going on in my realm, that means the Scions could have been here for 50 years!
That said, we seem to be entering a period of near equivalence. And thus, for the moment, you need not overly concern yourself with the passage of time.
How convenient.
As for your companions, however, Eustola and Uriange have dwelled here for 3 winters, all told, while Thancred's count stands at 5. Even our more recent arrivals, Alfino and Alize, have lived in the first for almost a year.
Alize is actually my favorite Scion, just saying. So great.
My intention had been to summon only you, but the art of reaching across worlds has proven exceedingly difficult to master. Thus it was that my fumbling hand closed upon those to whom your fate is most closely bound as well.
Just send your consciousness back in time. It'll definitely work. Yeah, whatever. I don't believe you for a second. And this guy clearly, as he said, sucks anyway at getting the right person, so... yeah. Alright.
Ugh. As they were not the object of my summons, their transference was incomplete. Though they may appear to possess corporeal bodies, they are, in truth, merely spirits that one can see and touch.
What? Wait a minute. Does that not...
okay, consequently, whatever. While you yourself will be able to pass between worlds with relative freedom, they will not. Much as it grieves me, they are stranded here, unable to return.
You dickwad. So how do I fix them back home? Then find a way to send them back. Yeah, no, this is me. They didn't have plot armor, of course.
We spent every waking hour searching for a way to reverse the summoning. In the beginning, at least. As you may have surmised, however, our efforts met with little success. And then we all but abandoned the endeavor once Uriange shared with us the vision he had witnessed during his journey through the rift.
Okay.
In that chaotic no man's land between realms, time and space warp and blend in unexpected ways. What Uriange saw was the future. That which would one day come to pass. In his vision of tomorrow, the first was rejoined with the source. This collision of worlds brought about the 8th Umbral Calamity and the deaths of countless multitudes. Amongst those who perished, Uriange clearly saw the fall of the Scion's mightiest champion. He watched you die.
Wait, what?
And thus did the Scions embrace their exile, and began searching this world for a means to forestall the coming catastrophe in yours.
Oh, so wait a minute. Plot armor revoked? So wait a minute. If I'm understanding this correctly, then We are the first, so that means that we die in our timeline? I don't know. Either that or we die here, in which case, again, dick. But anyway.
Their souls are stranded in the first, yes. But they have fought on, desperate to save their home and you from destruction.
Oh,
nor
isn't
have their
that
efforts
nice?
Been in vain. For it was they who finally established that the elimination of the Sin Eaters will indeed serve to prevent the calamity.
Oh, they're trying to save their world, okay.
Considering these circumstances of our meeting, you would be forgiven for doubting my version of events. And so, before all else, I would suggest you track down your comrades and hear the tale from their lips. I shall, of course, be happy to assist in these reunions, and you need not make any decisions regarding your involvement until you are certain of where you stand. Meanwhile, I promise I will not rest until I have found a way to help your friends return home.
Yeah, but now I'm gonna be stuck here because I've got to fix your
what
crap.
Say, have I earned your trust for the moment, at least?
I'll explain it more later, I don't want to say. Don't say it then, because yeah, the whole point of me doing this and streaming this and doing everything I'm doing right now is I want to experience it and record it because I like this, so. Do I have a choice? Yeah, for want of a better choice, that's what I would go with.
Excellent. You will not regret this. With that settled, we shall have to see about getting you ready for the road. Traveling across the rift has no doubt left you weary. I will arrange for a room where you might rest in comfort. While it's being prepared, perhaps I can show you around.
How about you tell me who you are? Take the dumbass hood off. Also, I would like to point out, he's got similar robes to an Ascian almost. Not exactly, but similar. So, anyway.
Best number is introduced, okay. Available at the end of this. Which means it's perfect. I guess past markets and come on. Okay.
Also, I have missed an Aetherite shop. It's this one, I think, that I'm missing. I've gotten everything else as far as I know. Because I grabbed this one. Grabbed this one. I'll figure it out in a minute. Figure you already know who he is if you know your lore. Well, unfortunately, I think I might know who it is because there's been some fan art getting thrown around. I might know who it is, unfortunately. Also, I do like the fact that they use the same, like, tower that they have the Red Mage CGI art from here, like, as the actual thing, because I think that was supposed to be the tower from
this is the, Musica
the 1.0 game.
The commercial
and yeah, spoilers.
What you might need to prepare for your journeys can be purchased here.
Cool. The Titania umbrella, that's cool. I'll explain it to you. Yep.
Ah, yes. You must be curious about the currency. Fear not. The gil you carry will serve you well enough.
I know it's probably not a Titania umbrella, but that looks like something Titania would fly around with. Explain
each
it to you.
Each nation once minted its own coins, but 'twas all a jumbled mess following the flood. After much debate, the local merchants eventually elected to revert to the old ways, wherein a coin's value was decided by the worth of its metal. As for a unit of measurement, we agreed upon the term gil, a word borrowed from coins uncovered within the Crystal Tower here.
How convenient.
And as our traders peddled their wares across the land, so too did our usage of gil become common practice. From what your stola tells me, a standard coin from the source equates to exactly one gil here, or near enough, not to matter. Our way of life has benefited greatly from the artifacts we recovered from the tower, some of which may be familiar to you.
Cash register? The tomes! Wait, he's selling phones! He's selling phones!
wounds! Oh my god!
But I fear it would not be practical for us to provide everything.
Oh, that's great!
You shall need a means to access the commodities of your homeworld.
Oh, that's so good.
Avan Kermsin?
Wait.
Yes, I'm here! Of course I'm here! What amusements do you have for me today?
What?
My dear Feo'ul. Paragon of Pixiekind. For you, I have the most vital task.
What?
This fine lady is a friend from a distant realm. And we have need of a means to ferry things back and forth from her home.
Okay, hold on.
Will you be able to assist us in this matter?
That's not what fairies sound like. Well, we'll find out what the English equivalent of fairies sound like, because I'm sure you're probably going to die a little inside with each new VA as you hear them.
You came from beyond, didn't you? From beyond the rift? How wonderfully exciting! What a brave and reckless and marvelous thing you did! You've the heart of a pixie, you do.
That voice is actually pretty bad. But it sounds very unapologetically like Scottish, so I'll roll with it for now.
After careful consideration, I have decided to grant you my assistance. Make a pact with me and the fun can begin.
Also, sounds like a damn dwarf. My disappointment is miserable. My day is ruined. I do know that meme. Also, Biggs. I have not heard Biggs and Wedge's voices in this game, or if I have, it's been so long that I don't remember them. They gave Biggs an Irish voice, and it is so good. I love it.
But answer me this, traveler. Did your garments come with you when you crossed over? Your teeth? Your nails?
I think so?
Just as I thought! Then you've a good stout connection with your home through which all your belongings, great and small, may easily pass. From this moment forth, I will be your Isnefis, and you my Sneyak. Like the branch which sprouts from the sapling, our bond will flow unbroken from one to the other.
I will be your beautiful branch and you my adorable sapling. Ooh, yeah.
Raise your hand.
I will say this, I am kind of glad it's not a generic fairy, like the
hey, listen
voice, but at the same time, yeah. Oh, cool. That's actually kind of cool.
'Tis done. We are bound now, dearest sapling. Come then. Make your request. Tell me your desire. I wish to visit this world of yours.
Mayhap her message to
Donation
your friends
in the sword. Donation center to turn on JV voice. I do not have any way to set up donations, and I do not plan to turn on Japanese voices. Appreciate it, though. That might be something I have to look into in the future if I can do this more regularly. Anyway, let's keep going. Who will you contact? That actually is an interesting discussion. If I send it to Kryle... Actually, what would I get for sending it to Kryle? Screw that. Go to Tataru.
Consider it done.
It's rough out here. Yo! I am... a non-existent streaming channel that gets on so irregularly that, like, there's no point. If I streamed every week and was consistent with it, maybe I'd set up, like, Streamlabs or something like that for donations. At this point, though, nah. And what are you gonna do? Float up through the giant white vapor cloud?
That was Feo'ul of the Pixies. Their kind possess an affinity for magic akin to that of arcane beings.
I'm not turning on JP. I want to hear the voices. The VAs for this is better than ARR. I don't know if you listen to ARR or not. ARR voices are awful. Actually, you know what? No, hold on.
They rarely show themselves in populated areas, but Feo is insatiably curious.
We're going to get through this quest, and then I'm going to show you some English voices. The American English. I wanted to hear them too, but not anymore. You're about to, whether you like it or not. Here we go.
We were going to organize a room for you, weren't we? Come along.
Okay. Trust me, the English is not as bad as that was just now, but it's pretty comical.
Come on.
Okay. As a result of your pact with Fei Ui, you now have access to delivery moogles, market boards, and summoning bells while in the first. Yay! So we're gonna make it so I can actually play the game the way it was meant to be played. Okay. I'm gonna hate my life for doing this, but... let's see. Because I need to do this for the event, let's do the Praetorium. And while I'm doing this, I can continue to do the quest queue and all that fun jazz. Hey, look at that. Look how quick that is. Nice. Oh, manager of suites. That's not what I need. Didn't quite get to the manager, but that's okay. Real talk. You check the JP version of Fair Louise cutscene, you'll see how crazy it is between English and Japan. Japanese. I'm sure, like, the Japanese voice acting in most things that are based from Japan are always going to be better. Not always. You get the rare time where you have, like, oh gosh, it's been forever since I've seen the show. What's his name from Cowboy Bebop? That everyone says, oh, the English voice actor did such a good job that even the original creator said it was better than the Japanese one. I don't know why, all I can think of is Vash, and I know that's wrong. Because I'm thinking of Vash the Stampede. Seeing how different her voice is in Japanese, she at least sounds like a fairy. I mean, yeah, Vash is Trigon. Thank you. And I'm thinking of Spike Spiegel. That's what I'm trying to remember. Nice. I gotta get that outfit. I like Lisa's outfit a lot. Okay. I know I'm going and doing older content when I should be doing the Shadowbringer stuff, but I want to do this just so I can get to English voice acting. That doesn't matter, at least to start. Alright. Yeah, well, the only problem is if you want to get the event stuff that's going on, you need to do this a lot. Because to get the event stuff, you're looking at a lot of dungeons. You can run, or you can run this, and it's much quicker. Also, I should be running right now, but I'm not. Non-skippable cutscenes for long dungeons should be a no-no. Well, that's why they don't do it anymore after this. That's also part of why, though, I'm okay with doing this, because of the fact that, again, you get to see the English voice acting whether you like it or not. Oh. I also need to be hitting that chug joke, because now... leveling! You're gonna run something I would have gotten on. I haven't done anything this day. Well, I mean, if you want to run this, you're more than welcome to. Oh, I should not be dodging stuff. Ooh, I should be dodging stuff. Anyway. I mean, if you want to hop on at any point today, that's fine. I just am going to be, if I do run anything, I'm running basically just this. Because this is 10 irregular tomestones, which gets you the cosmetic items for the wrap-up event for Shadowbringers the quickest. So that's why I'm running it. Also, if you're running stuff with me, you gotta understand you're gonna be running, like, Stormblood stuff at best. At worst, you're going to be doing some really old stuff.
Don't run specific dungeons, you need to do less.
Well, the reason why I run this specific dungeon is not for leveling. It's for... Let me in. Let me in. Let me in. Holy crap. You have several of these. I gotcha. Well, the only thing is that... Oh, wait. Oops, wrong button. So, as far as why I'm doing this, again, I'm doing it for the tombstones that you get for the special event before it runs out. Oh, really? I wasn't aware of that, because I was under the impression that you don't get tombstones by running the random dailies. You get tombstones by doing, like, the Praetorium a ton. I mean, if you want to hop on at some point, you're more than welcome to hop on, and I will happily run stuff with you. Just understand... It's going to be a lot of older stuff that you're running, that's all. There's a category for that, which is... to educate you? I'm still a babby leveling up in 14, so I do need to learn stuff. Either way, though. We're stuck listening to guys... Yo. I want to take a second... I don't care, like, if I put the stream up on YouTube later, if this just stays on Twitch, I don't care what, I have to say it. Gaius is a god. This dude is amazing. I love this character so much. I love Gaius so much as a character. He is so cool. Also, since we're waiting, I might as well hydrate. Gotta have that number one victory royale with my chug jug. I wanna die. Anyway. Also, yeah, I'm down. If you still want to grind some after this dungeon, we can group. I'm down. I'm very down. Also, can I just say, I am somewhat offended by the fact that this is the closest trench coat I can get for my character to actually look semi-decent. I am trying to build a Virgil cosplay for my samurai, and this is one of the only trench coats that female characters have access to in this game, other than the obnoxiously expensive rebel coat, and I forget what the other one is, but it's the same model. They are like a million gil a piece, which is not as bad as they used to be, but oh my gosh, they are stupid expensive. Just to get stuff for, like, certain glamours. It's ridiculous. Anyway. You know what? I am starting to slightly regret not queuing for something else. But it's okay. Looking for fashion tips. A raising question. Yes. So, I actually went to that Keitake, and the thing is that as I skimmed through there a lot, there were no trench coats. Like, button down the front, flayed back trench coats. Zero. For female characters in 14. That would fit on a samurai specifically. You can get something that's like an armless trench coat if you're a Dark Knight, which doesn't work for what I'm doing. Which does not work for what I'm doing. You can get a, Stand still. Oh my god, this is why I don't know. Thank god for sure. He doesn't last that long. Yeah, but no. If you're looking for a trench coat for a female character that works on samurai, there is basically nothing. There was a cosmetic item you could get that was a limited time event, crossover event that, because of legal reasons, they can never bring back again, which is also why the really coveted pistol that machinists really want is also in that event, and people get upset that you can't get another pistol. There's the Dark Knight trench coat thing that is the armless one, which again, Dark Knight, so I can't use it. Every other trench coat is either a Mog Station item or it's gender locked. So if I want a trench coat, I either have to pay for it, which is still gender locked, or I have to try and farm for it in game, but it's gender locked, which is stupid. But
What are you gonna do?
Other than if I Fantasia to a guy, which I mean, I guess I could do, but there's a reason why I picked the name Akima, and I did my character the way I did, is because I'm doing an homage to Titan AE, which is why Machinist will be my job of choice if I do a physical DPS. Titan AE is such a goddamn good name. Anyway. Oh wow, people actually killing them off. What a miracle. Nice. Machines is fine. I think mine is 60. Yeah, I got mine to 60 as well, and it's enough that I want it to be my main physical DPS job, but it's not enough that I'm gonna do it over, I mean, really, I'm not going to do a lot of jobs over each other. I like Red Mage too much because it's what got me into this game for me to give it up. So I don't foresee myself ever dropping Red Mage or anything else. If I have a tank, I like Dark Knight. That's the second job that got me into this. And then if I were to get to any other job, it'd be melee DPS, which is Ninja. And then lastly, I'd do Scholar for healing. So those are my four, like, main jobs. Definitely gonna give Reaper and the others a try, obviously, because it's the new jobs, but yeah. I have to get to the Gaius fight before I can start hearing English subs, but it's coming up quickly, so you'll get to hear the fun soon. Or sorry, English dubbing, not subbing. There are subtitles, but... somebody got lost. Aww, that's kind of cute. There's a bunch of people heading back and bringing them over. That's cute. Wait. Oh, we also have an LB2, so... hopefully one of the range will use it. That's the one thing I think people don't know about, is that if you have LB 1 or 2 for a boss fight, use it immediately so you can get the benefits. Someone died. Always remember to register for your match tick armor. It's a bitch if you forget that. Yes! I have found out the hard way about that. I actually felt horrible because one time I was running this and I thought everybody was here. I was like, okay, I'll hit the button. As the little action went through before I could stop myself and the elevator was going up, I see somebody running up to the elevator and I'm just like, no, I left someone behind. All right. Also, actually, I got teleported to the world of dark or the world of light because there was a piece of tech that had the same company as what Sid has? I think I know why, if I'm remembering stuff right, because it has to do with the twinning, but at the same time, I'll enjoy it as the story stuff comes up. All right. Come on. This arguably is a very cool mount for people to get right off the rip from ARR. Like the fact you do this dungeon and then you escape on it and then you just get it as a mount, that actually is really cool. Yet another reason why 14 is succeeding where Lizard is not. Just saying. That's... Sorry, I keep double checking over to my right because my setup is over here, so that's where chat everything is. Thank God for two monitors. Wait. Oh, they did get destroyed. Okay. Let's see. Parkour! Parkour! So that after the launch of Endwalker, like I think we're entering 7.1 or 6.1, we're going to get, we're going to get crossplay between all servers as long as you're in the same regional servers. So like all US servers get to play with each other, all Japanese servers get to play with each other, etc., which is really cool. So that means anybody that you want to play with that might not be on your data center. I'll be excited for that because my sister and her husband got into this game and I've been wanting to play with them really badly. How's life, good friends, as we wait for the 1,000 cutscenes to go by? I think you're probably the only one in here, Katsuki, okay, but still. How you doing? Normally, if this was like me playing through MSQ or anything like that, I wouldn't be focused as much on chat or I'd ignore everything on screen, but at this point, everybody who has played 14 would, you know, they've already seen this 1,000 times. Why the resident sleeper emote? You just bored over there? Hey, you know what? I'm getting through this quickly. I got you. I did this mainly so you could hear the amazing North American voice acting. I know. We're almost to the fun part, though. You get to hear the English voice acting very soon. So you're gonna look forward to that. The American voice acting specifically, I should say. Monk stuff! Let's go! This right here. This is the closest trench coat I can get, and it's got a gigantic titty widow. That is just sad. 14, give more trench coats. Give trench coats to women that don't have a boob window on it, please. Equal representation, is that tough? Anyway. His little calm thing. That's important, later. Oh my gosh, this music is good though. I will say that. If I can give Silken any credit, it's so good. You also hear Cid's voice a little bit. Yes. You do hear Gaius' voice, but you hear a little bit of Cid as he contacts you over the radio comms. But then after that, Cid's voice actually gets good. I like Cid's European voice. Like his British voice, English voice, whatever. Also, I did not know this because I had not run this place for a while. I eventually went back to run this because, obviously, the tombstone stuff. As I was running this, I found out that, as it turns out, the music from the last fight with Ultima here is the basis for the music they use for all the main weapons in Shadowbringers. So, like, Ruby weapon, Emerald weapon, etc. I did not know that. And as I'm listening through the music here, I'm like, oh, I know what this is from. I know what this inspired. So it's another good reason I ran this a lot. Also, I want this armor so bad. And they are a pain in the I have heard. That's one thing that I do want to try and do with Endwalker. The free company I'm with right now is someone that just recruited me because they wanted somebody to talk to and Discord call all the time, every single day. And I enjoy the person and hanging out with them every now and then, but not as much as they want me to. So when I get to Endwalker stuff and I really start enjoying myself and like getting to the point where I can do possibly Savage content, I'm gonna look for a free company that can run that. Because something tells me that even if we get a free company that can run it, or the company I'm in can run it, we're not gonna get far. So I want to experience content as it's current for once. All right, here we go. I do want Garlean armor. I really want Garlean armor. I want an entire tier of Garlean armor for everybody. Also, this music's pretty good too. If you actually stay with current content, we'll have to do it together this time, unlike Shepherds. I know. Thankfully, the reason why I'm even semi-hopeful for anything going forward is the fact that I have less than a month and a half left of school left, which means I am graduating this fall. I potentially have a job lined up, but that's not even a guarantee. Although that being said, this is a application heavy market where you can go and apply and they need people for jobs, which is great. So I might have a chance at that. If not, I can apply to other places and I have a better chance of getting a job. The only thing that'll interrupt me is if I move again, but I might be in a spot where I can actually enjoy content here, which is great. Nice! Because of the fact that I have a lot of stuff coming up that I have to do, and I'm not looking forward to it. As it is, last night I had to do an ER visit because I was having chest pains and I was having anxiety, so I needed to go to the ER to get myself checked out, which was not fun. It's also going to cost me a lot of money, unfortunately, but I'm in a position where I can afford it at least, which is why I even contemplated doing it. Again, graduation, getting a real job, getting a real health insurance plan, I can't wait. Come on. All right, come on. Yes, Nero ran away like a pain. Well, yeah. Instant part of the block, don't just take a mess about search, guys. Certain. No time to wait. All right. Getting 1/3 of all your income taxed away. You know what? At this point, you have income, though, and that's the big thing. The only thing I'm worried about is being able to balance out student loans mixed with living expenses mixed with everything. That's my only concern, is just making enough income that I can do all that. So. And at least on the plus side, too, it's money and you're independent. I'm not even independent right now, unfortunately, which bothers me a little bit, but at the cost of saving money, I'm not upset. As long as you graduate, they will work you on work. Yep. This is the way I want to go. No, I want to get to the terminal first. Oh, well. Here we go. And yeah, I'm here to graduate, which is great. Here we go.
Look for the LIPS control panel. It'll be somewhere nearby. Take the lid down, and you should find yourself in the chamber of the Ultima Weapon.
Oof, that English voice acting is so good. It's about to get even better. Are you ready for Gaius? Are you ready for Gaius's English VA? American VA, I should say? Eh? Here we go.
Keep your eyes peeled. Gaius could be waiting for you down there. Oh, and don't even think about dying. You're too bloody useful. The interference is getting worse. I don't think the connection will last much.
You were almost a Jill sandwich. Yeah, no kidding. Here we go, my boy. Horrible voice, but awesome.
Tell me, for whom do you fight? How very glib. And do you believe in Eorzea?
Come on, give me more. Give me more.
Eorzea's unity is forged of falsehoods. Its city-states are built on deceit. And its faith is an instrument of deception.
This voice acting,
it is
though.
Not but a cobweb of lies. To believe in Eorzea is to believe in nothing.
Yeah, I like Gaius's voice
in
acting
Eorzea,
a little bit,
the beast tribes
but it's still...
to fight in their stead.
When you hear, like, British guy's voice, it's like, mankind, nice.
Which is strange, is it not? Are the 12 otherwise engaged? I was given to understand they were your protectors. If you truly believe them your guardians, why do you not repeat the trick that served you so well at Cartano and call them down?
I can imagine the Japanese guy's is even better.
So long as you lavish them with crystals and gorge them on ether.
Ooh, I have a furry friend. Hello.
Your gods are no different from those of the beasts. Icons, okay. Everyone. Except but this, and you will see how Eorzea's fate is bleeding the land dry. Nor is this unknown to your masters. Which prompts the question.
I'm actually gonna mute real quick while this is running, because I'm gonna let my cat out, because she's been in here this whole time. Poor thing.
Men of learning, even the great Louis Soir, to grovel at their feet. The answer? Your masters lack the strength to do otherwise. For the world of man to mean anything, man must own the world. To this end, he hath fought ever to
I don't know if she wants out or not, but we'll see. She wants out, doors open now for her.
Conquest. And when the dust of battle settles, it
is
for
Jeff Goss, same thing. I actually haven't heard that voice yet. I've heard he does a really good job, because a lot of people told me, you should play the Japanese of MGS.
This, but a single path is open to the infinite.
I want this armor. I want this armor so bad. I want Garlean armor! Like, I want Garlean artifact gear or something. I do know that the current content, like the questing stuff you do for like the grind or whatever, you can get stuff that's similar to Garlean armor doing that stuff. Oh hell yeah, it's a different experience. I will have to give it a try at some point. The Metal Gear series is one of the few that I've beaten 2 and 3 for, and I need to get my PS3 out and working again for me to do 4. So, we'll see. I do own 5 on PC, though. We'll see. Again, Tower of Shame. Blah blah blah, haha, funny. He never plays his games. Move to speech JP if you finish this. Alright. Now, I can actually... Will the boss stand still? The answer is no. Although that being said, I can't tell if he's standing still or not with all the grindy graphics going on. I'll have to turn off allied graphics here soon. Transferred to Diabolos or Diablos. I did that about 2 or 3 months ago because of the fact that nobody I knew played on the server I was on other than you, I think. And when I found out the servers were linked, I figured it wouldn't be a big deal to group up cross server. So, or cross data center, whatever you call it.
Yet, you lack the resolve to put it to proper use. A waste.
Either way. He does the chuckle and he doesn't even... I know you're on Marlboro, but we can still play with each other. It's cider time, baby! Let's go! It's seen leave, but love to watch him go. Ba-dum-cha. Can't join any FCs or anything else on your server. If I can get into an FC that will do hardcore prog, I will transfer back happily. If I'm going to do stuff, I'll need to move over if you plan to stay there. I honestly don't care either way because I can play with anybody I want that's on the data center. That's what mattered to me. That's why I moved over to this server. In part because I had other people that were on this server, and because they want me to join their FC. I will probably leave the FC if they cannot do serious prog, but we'll see either way. Whatever I gotta do endgame prog, if I'm committing to it, that's all I care about, so.
Allow me then, hero, to do that which you will not.
Yeah, we'll figure it out at some point. Like I said, I'm not committing to anything until I know for sure I can commit to something, and real life takes precedence over being able to do prog in here, so. We'll see. Now we do the long-winded fight.
Bear witness to the true power of the Ultima Weapon.
Yes, yes, grand and all. I will give credit to Yoshi-P. They did a good job of taking care of the models and stuff, even for A Realm Reborn. Gods. spinning. This is why I don't mind. Oops, wrong song. Also, that is an awesome staff.
Can her strength truly be so great?
Yeah, that's...
It is the blessing of light that confounds you.
Laha Brea. Yeah, unfortunately that is the standard for pugs. Good tanks should keep the boss from spinning. There's actually a content creator named JoeCat who does some great videos, and one of the things he mentioned is, no matter what tank you play, you are horrible at dancing, because you should not be trying to spin the boss
so,
like it's disco night.
This is what empowers her.
Beyond mortal limits. If you are to prevail, the hammer of darkness must needs be brought to bear upon the shield of light.
Also, Black Mage gets Ultima for the new finisher when?
For the Ultima weapon is host to a power of which you are as yet ignorant.
Actually, I had, while we're letting this go, I had an interesting conversation with a friend of mine today who plays 14. So, if you look at DPS in 14 right now, you have, this one's pretty meh. Yeah, this one's okay. Yeah, oh, Laha Brea's voice, yes.
The magic within
in 14, if you look at the DPS, there are a few different categories of DPS. You have melee DPS, physical range DPS, and casting range DPS. What I think is interesting is that originally there were not that many ranged DPS, but even early on, they split the DPS as physical DPS and magic DPS, because you had Bard, Summoner, and Black Mage. Then you got Machinist, so that made 2 and 2. Then you got Red Mage, then you got Dancer. So there's a pretty clear split between the different DPS. And when you look at them, you've got Summoner, Red Mage, and Black Mage, who are casters, so they have longer casts, they have to plant their feet, they got certain criteria that make them a ranged casting DPS. When you look at like Bard, Machinist, and Red, or Dancer, sorry, when you look at those three DPS, you actually have the job that can be very mobile and has some utility, but it doesn't do a lot of damage compared to those that can plant their feet. I'm kind of curious to see when they decide to do magic-based melee DPS and physical damage-based melee DPS. And the concept behind that that I thought of was, usually for the very physical-heavy melee DPS, they're the ones that they have a 1-2-3 rotation, or like a 1-5 rotation or whatever, that's very repetitive and is the main source of their damage. Whereas if you look at like Ninja and what's soon to be Reaper, both of those jobs, from everything we understand so far, are more oriented around magic-based damage. Like Reaper uses a 1-2-3 rotation as a filler to get to its like big heavy-hitting void abilities. And with Ninja, your 1-2-3 is a way to help extend your increased auto attack speeds and as a way to kind of fill in the time between with damage. Your main gimmick... The main gimmick, sorry, I saw a talk I posted here. I'll get to that in a second. The main gimmick is that you're doing your mudras and your ninjutsus and stuff to do damage. It seems not sure how it would work. You would be some melee class with magic to, like, buff yourself, I guess. That's actually what I was kind of thinking a little bit. I thought there's no two one-handed weapon wielders in the game, so you could do, like, two one-handed swords or one-handed maces or whatever. And you do something like an enchanter. Certain attacks you do augment your weapons to have, like, fire in one hand and water in the other hand, and then you have a finisher that does like boil, and it does a big heavy hitting finisher with the certain kind of enhancements you do, and you use the four basic elements for all your buffs and finishers. In between that, to get like meter back or whatever, you do your 1-2-3 rotation to help supplement that. Plus, the cool thing is if you do like enchanter and you're augmenting your weapons with elements, the cool thing is you can even do astral and umbral. So you can do like a certain attack and give it a light effect, which could like maybe heal you or give your party a passive buff or something like that. Nothing too crazy, but just as a way to kind of play into that. And then if you do umbral and you're trying to maximize damage, you can maximize damage by doing like umbral boil or umbral surge or something like that. So you use it as a the 1-2-3 rotation as a filler, and you do a little more magic-oriented damage as a melee DPS. And again, the cool thing would be you wouldn't have to do a lot to retool Reaper or Ninja, because they already have magic elements to them, so you could even lean the damage more into... you could lean the damage a lot more into their magic casting abilities and pull the damage back into their physical abilities. And I have to true north this already. Watch me dodge as much of this as I can. Okay. I'm hoping I can dodge every single one of these two lines and be a badass, but we'll see. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Okay, actually, nope, lost instant still, of course not. Oh my gosh! Brains, do your job! Ah, I almost got it. Okay. It'll be interesting, though it sounds complex. That's kind of the idea, is that most of the magic melee DPS are a little complex when you think about it, because Ninja is very fast-paced. You're doing your mudras and your ninjutsus, and depending on the specific sequence you're doing, you get a specific effect. With Enchanter, the idea is that it's just you get one element in one hand, one element in another, you combine them together, and you do big damage with that element. I wouldn't worry too much about, like, certain buffs or whatever, but I would make it so that, like, certain combinations of elements either do single target or AoE damage. I haven't thought the system completely through yet for Enchanter, which is what I kind of like jokingly named the job as like a concept. But the idea is that that'd be pretty hard APM wise. Not really, because what you could do for a gauge is you could have like your left weapon and right weapon, and on the gauges you could see like, oh, this is red, and your left hand weapon will always have fire. So like, good example, your right hand will always have either earth or water, and your left hand will always have wind or fire. And depending on the combination that you do, depends on, well, no, actually you don't even need to do that. If you think about it, you could do any two combination of elements you want, and it would just show you what element you create. And then you can just dump that element right there and then and get a certain effect.
Pathetic.
I'd have to think it through the rest of the way, but the concept is there of like, I want...
Of unrivaled power.
You if it was locked, that's true.
With the ultimate weapon. The ultimate magic.
Well, and the other idea I had is that it's not I guess if I explain it a little bit better, then it'll kind of help make things make more sense. When I'm saying when you use an element, I'm not saying like you charge an element in one, you charge an element in the other, and then you go. What I'm saying is that like you do an attack that's an elemental based attack, then you do another attack that's an elemental based attack, and then your finisher is that way. It's almost like if you think of Samurai, how Samurai has a 1-2-3 rotation, and two of those rotations have the same opener. Actually, no, all three of them have the same opener.
Will be warped beyond all recognition.
That's true, actually. If you could pick your stuff, that gets crazy.
Heidelin.
I'd have to think about it a bit. To me, the concept of, like on parasite, one weapon, you lock specific attacks that are, like, specific to single target or AoE, and it's specific and elements, that might work, but it also kind of limits the creativity. So, like,
her complete excision.
If you have two elements combined, like fire and water, fire and water can make, like, a boiling attack.
A chaotic yeah, it would be difficult.
That is true. I'd have to think about it more, but the concept at its core, I think, is a pretty cool idea. Having a magic-based DPS where, by augmenting your abilities through your blades and getting certain elements, when you combine together, they do certain finishers. Like,
this endeavor.
You could do wind and water and do, like, an ice attack that's AoE specific. Well, I guess it's the other thing. Yeah, the execution would be the hard part. I can see that. I don't know, maybe if you only do specific elements, create specific finishers, that could help too. Like, for example, two of your elemental finishers are either AoE, or no, two of your elemental combination finishers are AoE, and two of your elemental combo finishers are single target. That might help it as well, if you can limit it down like that. We'll see. I'll have to think more on it, but... Whoa! Okay. Also, this guy's gonna go down so fast. And Heidelin! Those Heidelin things! Let me get by the gate. Everybody's already at the gate, ready to go. And I leveled up. Nice. And let me quickly give the commendation to the least appreciated job in here. And I'll give it to a DPS, I guess. Okay. Yes, I know. For once. All right, brudda, if you want to hop in, I am happy to play. Barrel my crap real quick, though. I guess I'll send you the invites. I believe this is... unless I'm stupid. Your character is Luna, right? Yeah, that's what I thought. Now, the only thing I don't know about... here, let me use the Aether, right? And I'll pop over to your world real quick. Which I can teleport to Plaza. Let me do this. Won't let me visit another world. Interesting. Oh, because you have to make it your home Aetherite Plaza, that's why. No, it won't. Okay, awesome. Let me teleport to the Golden Saucer and then I'll pop over to your world. Oh, and actually, while I'm here, I can do my mini cactpot and then cry in a corridor. I don't even know if there's anything I desperately want from the Golden Saucer. But I'm here, so I might as well do it. Yeah. If I do 12, that's only 108. Let's try, I think it's 789. Golden Saucer is one of those things you do as like a filler thing in between everything. Now we got 180. Well, still net positive, which is good. Jeez, this is a borked card. I guess this for 678. Hey, look at that. There we go. Can't stand the RNG, I'm not a gambler. Fair enough. Alright, well, this is the obvious pick I can do. And it worked. Okay. The nice thing about the Golden Saucer is that you don't even need to gamble necessarily. If you want a very quick way to make Gold Saucer coins, which this is something I figured out a while ago, I'll show it real quick and then I'll hop on the ship and go to your server, but I'll show this real fast first. So, easiest way, I'm going to teach everyone out there this, easiest way to make MGP, do this minigame out on a limb, it is extremely easy, it just is a timing-based minigame.